Yet another evening, another adventure. This time I'm actually going to try to explore the church a little bit further. This late at night. What evening? The clock is at approximately 10 past 11. And it's actually always creepy. And even though I'm actually in a lit up place, I always seem to see things that might not be the best. I mean, I'm definitely going to freak myself out. No doubt about it. After a while, when I actually walk, even my headset is going to freak me out. The creaky. How about a legend? I think it is a Japanese legend about a woman approximately 6-7 feet tall. Her name is Hashino, something like that, but I don't really remember. And he makes this really weird sound that goes like this: po, 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 po. She's always after children. If anyone actually, if any kid actually encounters this creature, they have to lock the kid inside. Without any windows, and lock the door after them. And have a paper blessed by the think it's a priest, Buddhist priest or something. And then he should be inside with that pepper for 7 days. And afterwards you have to move from the house. And the child's grandparents is exactly what is supposed to be done. But yet, still they hear the sound, po, po, po. And the being actually followed them. And when the creature, and they thought they actually had outrun the creature, she actually caught up with them and grabbed the kid, never to be seen again. And another creepy pasta is actually Lady in White. The story about a lady in white is always the same. A woman that's been betrayed by her husband. She's going temporarily insane and kills her own kids. After that, when she realizes what she's done, she kills herself. And if she ever finds a man that's unfaithful to their wives, she kills them. Another creepypasta. I know that I have been thinking, talked about Slenderman, and there's actually a lot of places I want to go, to be honest. One, I think it's in California. It's actually a boat that has a lot of history. I think it was twice as big as the Titanic. First, they built it to get cargo and something like that overseas. When World War II started, it was used I thought I heard a weird sound. Not my footsteps, not the creaking, but footsteps that were actually to the right. Inside somewhere, it was just a brief footstep. But anyway, Queen Mary has probably the most, after the Second World War, it became a tourist attraction. A tourist attraction with a history of a lot of deaths. I think 4 or 5 has died in the pool area alone. And if I'm not mistaken or mistaken, I actually also think that people that lives in a particular room at that boat they went insane, straight up bonkers. In the same room, people have actually died. And one crewman actually died, ironically, by the steel door number 13. Back in the day also, in the engine room, people have died. So it's now believed to be haunted that the entire ship and the most haunted room of them all, they have closed it, ripped out all the furniture, ripped the room number from the door, and that room is the room B340. Room B340 is said to be before you actually enter that room, you have to knock on the door to respect the spirits. Oh, it's so creepy. I cannot believe that I'm actually doing this.
is not going to set off for another 44, 30, 29 minutes. It's fucking plenty of time. So I'm not here close. I might actually put my headgear on. My head so that it doesn't creak so extreme. It's quite a lot of noises. That over there actually looks like a child against the tree. Can't really get a clear fix on it. There somewhere. Find somewhere and try it. Doesn't that look like a child? Doesn't that actually look like...
where I actually turn the camera more than my head is that. Have been known to actually spot weird frequencies in the lights back from. Things that our eyes, a human eyes, can't really see. But it was something to that. Ever since I actually began all my rituals, like Bloody Mary, Daruma-san, messed with Zozo, weird things have actually been happening in my apartment. Cover for my stove, the cover for my fan above the stove. I actually noticed that it was somehow put down on my stove. No reasonable explanation. My cat is actually reacting to creaks in the house in my apartment. And earlier today, when I came home from my grocery shopping and was ready to go to bed and sleep because I was so extremely tired at that moment, something really spooked him. Something actually did spook him. And he just jumped. It seemed like he saw something out of the ordinary, or if something actually grabbed him. Something grabbed him, or he saw something out of the ordinary. It's actually so weird. He's never reacted like that. Not unless actually vacuum cleaned the house. So I wonder what the hell it was. It's just weird. Check my footage later and see if I caught something weird on camera. Anyways, guys, this is actually where I drop out. Instead of the ghost paper challenge, I do this. Like, subscribe, and comment if you actually see something weird out of the ordinary. That you might actually think isn't supposed to be here. And anyway, Mr. and Mrs.